Twitch, trap, blah, 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 now I have my voice back. Welcome to twitch.tv/EvilSqueegee. I am Evil Squeegee, and this is Judas Steer. Finally, at long last. Nobody cares about that torch.
I honestly God thought he was going to say Everdeep.
Okay, so, it's been a while since we played. Alright, it's been a while since we played. I get that. Alright. Hashtag deal with it.
Hashtag September has ended.
Oh my god. September is over. September was so
awesome. So somebody could wake me up. That'd be great.
So busy. You have no idea. All right. I had the thing I'd been planning. The week that I've been planning for 2 years. Then I had TwitchCon. Then a family thing. And these were all spaced out such that I was not even on my channel for an entire week pretty much over the course of all of September.
He says that as though most of us weren't fucking here in his absence.
What the hell is wrong with testing?
I'm hearing you fine. There's something in OBS. Like, your volume has not changed for me.
That is true. It's the same for me.
Yeah, but on stream it's quiet, but in here it's fine.
Okay. I don't. Let's bump it up by 50% here. Testing. How am I now? Did the microphone bite the dust? Like, the fuck?
No, your microphone hasn't been the dust. It's OBS being a shitlord.
Maybe it was unhappy because it heard me saying I was going to be going to XSplit soon. There, how's that?
I can't tell you because it's Twitch and there's a delay.
Test. Okay, so the point is, God, I actually have to yell at my microphone now. Like, what the fuck? What is going on? Ladies and gentlemen, a live show.
Broadcasting from a live studio audience.
All right, so I'm seeing the people are okay. So here's the deal. All right, September's over. We could get back into the game. Deadlands. We left off on a killer moment.
Yeah. Now I don't feel bad for my Green Day joke.
God, okay, so here's the deal. I'm just going to turn this down. Like, talk, get me visual confirmation.
Your mother.
I thought you were saying hashtag, like, I thought test, you were talking test, about...
Test, test, test. All right, so I'm going to be loud by comparison to the rest of you, but I don't fucking... God, try now.
What are we trying?
What
are
talking?
Should we say things?
I have no idea. Okay.
Words so
just
that...
be Matt. Just let
be...
the Matt no. flow
no.
through.
No, never. You can't make
don't
me.
Like being Matt.
Mattnition.
No, not doing it.
Did you just say Mattnition?
Yes.
Mattnition.
And then the Matt Nation attacked. That's all we have all right. to know, right?
Chad's saying it's good now.
That's the entirety of this year.
And then it is Hurricane Matthew. I'm not even
Hurricane
fucking
Matthew.
With you. It's Hurricane Matthew.
My brother's name is also Matthew. So.
All right, so the mics are seeming balanced. Okay, I don't know what the hell was wrong there, but it was, and I apologize. The point is, all right, September is over. I am back. We can get back on track. We can have more Judas Steer. We can have more.
Guess who's back?
All right. Guess who's back? Back again. Grant is back. Run like hell.
Run like hell.
Thank you for taking my absolute flop of a joke and actually doing something with it, Chris. Bravo. You refused to acknowledge that was a dumb joke, and you just took it and you validated me, and I feel... This is not why we are friends, but if I didn't already have good reasons for that, this would be why we were friends.
Sure, we'll go with that. Why not?
The truth is, Chris, we're just at this point we're friends because I've invested too much to not be friends.
Thanks, Paul.
No, for real though, it is time to play. Okay, Sarah.
Yeah.
I'm writing out Sam.
Yeah.
You're gonna be playing Harley today.
We rerolled this morning. Yeah.
All right. So tell us a little bit about Harley.
Well, Harley, she's a gnome ranger with a level of rogue, and she is sneaky, and she recently went through a change where she experienced a lot of really difficult times in her life and overcame them, and now she's a lot stronger for it, and she's pretty badass, so she's going to have a steampunk bow, like crossbow, that functions on ghost rock, and is super powerful and strong, and can fire like 16 arrows at once. Yeah. That sounds good. Casually gives self super badass powers.
As one does.
All right, and then...
Jack, we're trolling you, man.
For all this and more, tune in to twitch.tv/evilsqueegee. Every day at 10 a.m. EST. Except Saturdays at 4 p.m. EST.
That's Evil Squeegee time.
EST for Evil Squeegee.
Yes, that.
Indeed. I second that motion, yes.
Oh, we have confused everyone.
Ignia, the reason... Igina, Ignia, Ignia.
I can't say anything because my interpretation...
Igina. The only reason it says Sam is because I didn't get around to updating the graphics yet because September was so busy.
Igina Draney.
So don't be fooled. She's not Sam today. She's playing Harley. We just haven't had any chance to do any technical stuff. In the meanwhile, while Serapy is scrambling to find Harley's Deadland sheet, we're having a Discord party at the end of this month. Be there. It's for subscribers only. However, that doesn't mean you have to be spending lots of money to be there. There is now a $1 per month subscription level. You too can be a scrub-scribe. For just $1 a month. And, what else? T-shirts. If you guys want t-shirts, okay? We're going to be launching a t-shirt shop. We're going to be launching a merchandise store, okay? Going to be awesome. However, there's going to be a limited edition run of shirts that you will only be able to get when we launch this shop. It'll be like the opening, like build up to the shop, right? And it's going to be a one of a kind t-shirt that you will not be able to get at any other point.
World first.
But we have designed it yet because I'm waiting for you guys to tell me what you want as a t-shirt. All right.
I swear to God.
So hop on Discord at discord.me/nerdherd and hop into hashtag the will of the people and let us know what you think for shirts.
I'm not letting the Finthias shirt happen. I'm not.
I am right there with you.
Fortunately, since Finthias doesn't use your face, I don't have to have your permission for that.
That's not true. The character is my intellectual property.
Show that to me in writing.
You don't have to have it in writing for intellectual property. Otherwise, anybody on TV would not be subject to intellectual property.
The entire show says created by Evil Squeegee in the credits. Plus, Finthias isn't your character. Finthias is its own thing. You can't own that.
Finthias is not its own character.
Yes, it is. Finthias is actually a fan mashing of two characters.
A fashing.
Yeah, those.
And as long as I do not actually depict Matthias, assuming I can't, which I can. As long as I do not depict Matthias in a copyrighted image, like I don't use any copyrighted artwork of Matthias, and assuming I do not include any actually copyrighted intellectual properties, I can make as many of those shirts as I want. Also, let us not forget fair use, parodies, and fan art being a viable source of selling.
Oh, I forgot about fan art. I forgot fan art was actually viable marketing.
Yep. Today on twitch.evilsqueegee, we talk about how to screw over Chris using the law. Actual, real, live rules lawyering.
Man, this is just like that time in prison.
The only real, I think, option would be if you actually became Matthias and then you could sue him for like libel or something. You have to change your name. And
okay,
you have to-
at no point do I think me actually geographically accurately becoming Matthias is a good idea for anybody.
I agree, but I mean, if you really want to get back at him and not have this happen.
You know, I will say, in the realm of bullshit that Grant and I have done, getting back at each other by getting a legal name change is not outside the realm of possibility.
I have been friends with Chris for a long time.
I suggested it.
I believe one of the first things Chris and I actually said to each other were, nom 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 nom! Like, actually, truly one of the first things we said to each other.
Wow.
It's that kind of relationship. Okay, so we got the Discord party, we got the shirts coming out, we got I have begun working on a super secret project. We've got a lot of cool people coming up on the show in the next month or so. Super secret people, because I forget their names because I'm not looking at the shirt at the spread shirt right now.
The spread shirt?
Yeah.
Okay. Just wanted to make sure I heard that right.
Also, Robovan has a point, Chris.
What's that?
You can't be Matthias. You'd have to drop kick your computer. Alright. So, in review, because it's been a while, let's do some catch up here, okay? First off, does anybody want to cash in any chips? Sam and Finn seem to be out of chips. Matthias, do you want to cash in and join us in the 000 club?
No, I'm going to keep a hold of the one blue and the inevitability of my own demise.
All right, so you're going to cash in the two white and the one red?
Yes, I thought I had.
You have not. You need to edit that.
Okay.
And then we all get to draw chips. That's what
yes,
we do.
We'll
so let me hop chips. Over here and hit. Then,
holy word, holy word, holy word. Because I'm going to need it today.
Yeah.
Ooh, thank you for the host, How Reroll. I appreciate that, man. If you guys haven't checked out How Reroll, do that now. How Reroll is they do more evening content, but they are a very character-centric, improv-driven show. And Serranos, I'm not thanking you for the host. Fuck off. All right, so these are for Kajer. 1, 2, 3. These are for Sam. 1, 2, 3. These are for Finn. 1, 2, 3. And these are for me. 1, 2, 3. What did I get? I got a red, white, and blue.
How nice. Very patriotic of you.
Can somebody update my chips? Thank you. Because I have to check this other thing over here, and while we are doing that, it's time for the holy word. 3, 2.
Where the fuck have my whispers? How do I whisper?
/W scrub through loop.
Yeah, but I want my
cognition. Cognition. The fuck are they doing? Well, son, that's how we done find our accent for the show, because it is a downright channel rule that when you are playing Deadlands, you must have an awful southern accent. It must be fake, it must be terrible, and it must be consistent. You must not ever play Deadlands without having a southern accent, and this is a rule. You would not be surprised the number of people who have come along and been like, I don't want to play somebody from the south, I want to play somebody from the north, or I want to play somebody from across the pond. Screw you, even Zangmak had to do an accent. He actually played a character who was faking a shitty accent just in order to do that.
That is correct.
So, when we last left off here, alright, the posse is hot on the trail of the man that never sleeps, otherwise known as Puck. Sam, you are under the impression that Puck is very much your twin. Are you the eldest?
No, I'm not.
Alright, he's the, your older brother.
He's older by 4 minutes.
Your older twin brother.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm gonna take a moment here, real quick. Jax, your explanation is in the rules. I'm the one who decides whose streams are gonna be discussed in my chat. We don't talk about other people's streams in this chat very often, because this chat ain't a billboard for advertising your stuff. It's in the chat rules. There's a reason why it has not been explained, because you have to read the rules in order to be in the chat in the first place. So I will thank you kindly to stop complaining. Where was I?
Puck.
Puck! Alright, so you are under the impression of Puck because you're missing twin brother. He went missing during the war. And you have been attempting to work up the cash to fund your search for Puck. Although, Puck is not the name you know him by. You only found out about this because you hunted down the son of a bitch that double-crossed you and stole your treasure, only to find out that the man that collected that treasure was Puck, this ancient engine gold. Started this whole mess. Now, you tracked him all the way through this village. Along the way, you rescued Emmy from certain doom. Emmy was the sheriff of Tombstone until she was chased out, accused of witchcraft. You have since learned that perhaps those accusations were not entirely baseless, since she seems to be fully aware of the supernatural, just chooses not to engage you at that level. And as you are not explaining yourself to her unnecessarily, she has returned that favor in kind, resulting in a mysterious relationship with Emmy, who is a little soft of stomach, but otherwise seems to be looking out in your best interest, for the most part, best we can tell. From there, you entered this town and, met most of the locals, only to find out that by this point, most of them are dead. See, you are in the town of, I think I call it Minesville, because it is this tiny little settlement out in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of the desert. You're headed north from Tombstone. And, there is a sandstorm raging. These sandstorms are mighty fierce. They will strip the flesh right off a man's bones. And as such, because they are so common in this area, there is a little network of tunnels that has been dug out underneath the town. You were down there helping the townsfolk getting out some water when an earthquake happened, knocked y'all out, and you were looking for Sally, the preacher's daughter. You have since killed the preacher because he done lost his mind and tried to kill y'all. But that's not the point. The point is Sally is this little girl who's been crushing on Puck, best you can tell. And she was headed into the mines to go get something. And that's the last you heard of her. Well, you've done some digging. You found your way past the steam pump machine. And you are now in the mines looking for Sally. Because what else are you going to do? You could head up top, but the whole town done got slaughtered by prairie ticks. And you are
fools
looking for the heart of the evil that haunts these mines. Mm-hmm. Now, in the process of doing so, Sam, you've done exploded. It was an unfortunate series of events, and it resulted in you being on fire, which was terrible, considering that you, as a mad scientist, praise and hail the properties of gunpowder, be they real or just imagined, is irrelevant. And since you are covered in gunpowder, it's all up in your nose, it's in your guns, you got little packets of it, you done exploded. Mm-hmm. As your flaming corpse lay on the ground, Matthias the huckster, the spellcaster, the preacher gone witch, struck a deal with a powerful spirit that haunts the mines. And that powerful spirit done possessed your corpse. And in a fearful and fearfully powerful kind of way, that demon learned real quick that your spirit was not one that was easily contended with. If there is one trait that Sam has carried with her from the beginning of her life all the way to this point, it is determination and fearlessness. Sure, she might get her feathers ruffled on occasion, but you ain't never seen a bigger set of balls than are hanging between this lady's legs, let me tell you what. And as a result of that, I do believe you grappled and slammed around this demon in your own mindscape, and you are in control of your own corpse.
Mm-hmm.
And you are going to be learning that this demon has all kinds of powers that you can browbeat out of it. But it was as your corpse, now permanently crispy from the waist down, was starting to stand back up. Emmy has just witnessed the death of Sam and is pale as she can be. Finn, you just dove in front of her to take shrapnel from the explosion so that she didn't have to. And Matthias, you are bleeding from the arm, missing a few cards because they're sitting on top of Sam's body. Now, with Doubt and Thomas flying around, no telling what Sam's reaction to being brought back is going to be. And Matthias just trying to keep everything together. I'm Evil Squeegee. I'm your marshal. And this is Judas Steer. And this. God damn it. Hold on. This ain't good. Can I get... What? And this is not Judas Steer at all. This is a black screen. This is going to be... quickly fixed. And this is Technical Difficulties, the show. Technical difficulties. Hey!
Your mama forgot. I know it hurts. Rolling by the cool kids on the first day of school. I know it hurts so bad. Let it go.
Alright, now that I done fixed that, hello! Welcome. You guys ready?
Define ready.
Let's get right to
ready
this.
Ready as I'll ever be.
Sam, your cold, dead hand slams down, palm first onto the ground in front of you, scorched as it may be. The dirt of the mine floor grits against your palm, but you don't rightly care. Your heart doesn't exactly beat, and that's a very strange sensation as you kind of push yourself up. And there's Matthias standing over you with a solemn look on his face.
Did you fix it? Did you fix me? I'll touch my face, like, indicating that. I mean, like, physical healing.
No, there's no fixing what's been done to you.
I get a flashback from what I saw in my mind, fighting a tentacled, many-eyed monster. And it screams at me, very short. It cackles in my head. I look down at the cards that have slipped to the ground, see the blood and the dust, and I look at Matthias. What the hell have you done?
I'll reach down, gather up the cards, brush them off. Same thing I always do. What I have to. I'll tip my hat.
Not good enough. Don't you walk away from me. Tell me what you did.
I brought you back.
Why?
Because I can't have you dying before you find that brother of yours. Wouldn't be right.
I can't live like this.
Well, ain't nobody said you'd be living. I just said you'd be back.
I feel like I can do anything. And that scares me.
Good. Keep the fear. It'll keep you human, mostly.
I look down at what's left of me. I see through holes in my pants from our misadventures. My skin, mottled, crispy. Look at my hands. One of them's still metal. That's good news. But one of them, where I squelched the bug juice, mottled, disgusting, scarred. And I realized that I haven't taken a breath since we started having this conversation, I think. I can still do it.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of acting. I recommend drinking, too.
How do you know what I am?
I only seen two things come back. And you're not trying to eat me yet.
Tell me more.
I ain't got much.
Whatever you have, Matthias.
Just don't lose your head.
I sit back and ponder this and realize there are two meanings to that sentence. I've learned enough of Matthias to know that he says things that usually have layers of meaning. And I nod. And then I look over to Finn and Emmy to see what they're doing.
What do you mean? She just exploded. Of course you saw that. Hey, no, Emmy. Look at my ass.
You're still muted, sweetie.
So, sorry. This is rewind, right? And Emmy has just said the words, "I didn't see that."
Of course it is. She just exploded. Emmy, look at my eyes. It'll be all right.
You have never seen skin so dark, go so pale. She's wearing that tattered, fancy green dress of hers. she done insists on wearing everywhere. It is filthy, torn, blood-stained, got holes in it from bullets, claws, bug juice, and worse. At this point, little fringes around the edge of the dress kind of charred from having unfortunate brushing accidents with the train tracks from earlier. And despite that, you ain't never seen her afraid. She walks through the world with a soft heart but enough confidence to power a presidency. She never doubts nothing. She always seems to be a step ahead. That might be why, in this moment, she looks so horrified. Because, for once in her life, she don't know what to do.
Emmy? Emmy, breathe. Breathe. In. Out.
And she's gonna lose her lunch sitting next to her, because I'm gonna hyperventilate if I keep doing that on camera.
I'm gonna hold back her hair and make sure she doesn't, you know, suddenly start choking on her own hair.
It's about that time that you're looking to Emmy, Sam. She vanishes, and the first thing that she looks at as she pulls her head up is you. You make eye contact for a moment, and you see an uncertainty in her gaze that you ain't never seen before. And she looks back down at the ground.
Oh, now the two are kind of staring off at each other.
$15 to Jex. He gets a destiny token, and that's $5 left over if the Moz can handle that.
While the two are staring at each other, not sure what to say, I'm going to tip my hat over my face, and I'll say, for what it's worth, though, I am sorry. And then I'll start heading into the mines.
Come on, Emmy, let's...
I'm going to stand up, finally. Feeling nothing. And I'm going to try to reach inside myself, because I'm aware that something is different.
All right.
I know that I just experienced some sort of nightmare.
Yep.
That I don't fully understand. I don't really know what I'm looking for exactly.
Doesn't matter what you're looking for. I know what you find.
I knew you would.
You reach into yourself. And you feel a wriggling, a writhing. It's a little wet, smells like seawater. And inside of you is something big, something dark. You can't straight up read malicious, but it definitely don't have anybody's best interest in mind, that's for certain. And for a moment, you can almost see in your imagination, not that you were the one imagining this, but your imagination delivers unto you the image of an eyelid snapping open and an eyeball looking back and forth.
Oh, I remember. You, the beast.
Enjoy your inside, little girl.
You need to understand one thing. When I'm finished, we're done.
Sure.
You laugh, but I was just given the key to end you.
No guts, no glory.
I think you know I got plenty of guts.
For now. You got all the power for the time being. But you best be understanding that ain't always gonna be the case. I fully intend on paying all respects mutually, or lack thereof. And when you're not on top, you got a whole life for me to toy with.
What could you possibly want out here?
Leave it to the meat suits to not know what they got. Well, suppose the stories are just gonna have to be true. You don't know what life is until it's over. Happy trails.
I want to tell it to shut up. I want to tell it to go away. But I know that I'm trapped in a body with this thing. So I grit my teeth and say nothing and follow Matthias into the mine.
Finn? The other two seem to be wandering off without even a word of explanation.
You're muted.
You mutter something under your breath that even the audience can't hear. No.
Emmy, it looks like Sam's okay. We need to go.
Thank God for that.
Thank God indeed. Come on. And I try to help her up.
All right.
And I start following them into the mines.
God ain't got no place here.
All right. Now, y'all got a bit of a problem down here, Matthias.
Can I get a white trip?
It is dark as hell, and you may. Get yourself a white chip. I'm gonna actually give everybody involved a white chip.
Okay.
Sam for giving such delicious flavor to the waking moments of a hard road. Matthias. That is probably the most Matthias I've seen you be in at least two campaigns. Now. As you're wandering down this hallway, Matthias, it strikes you. It is dark as hell down here.
Yeah, but I'm still part of the darkness.
For the most part. You still gotta see.
Do I got one of them torches?
No, but as you start to realize that your magic is starting to fade, Sam will come up behind you holding her electric light.
I seem to be stuck in that wall.
Somewhere behind you, you hear, boom, ow! No, you don't. That's not actually what happens. I'm not certain. How did you dumb place yourself inside the damn wall, Finn?
I don't know.
All right. Lady ladies and gentlemen, the amazing, one-of-a-kind Finn, the man who knows no wall from the inside.
Yes, sir.
He walks through one side of the wall. He cannot walk back through. Science cannot explain him.
Science.
You might say that he's Step on the right outside.
And witness the amazing, the impossible. Where the fuck aren't we on this map?
You might say that he's on the outside. He's looking in.
He's on the outside. And he's looking in. And he can't see you, not through this wall, cause he's inside it. Where the fuck's he?
As the rest of them come up behind me, I'm not gonna be looking at any of them. I'm gonna still have my hat down over my eyes and just keep my head, I'm going to keep facing straight ahead, sorry, and not walk directly into the crystal.
That's a pretty damn good idea, ain't it?
Yeah.
Why are we not touching those crystals again?
Because they infect you.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Say what, Sam?
Are you conveying shame? What sense am I getting from your body language?
Give me a scrutinize, or not a scrutinize,
No, it'd be...
Yeah, that'd be scrutinize.
Give me a scrutinize.
The one tap, I get to use scrutinize.
Yeah, go ahead.
That and not search.
Give me a scrutinize roll.
Don't deny me.
Don't deny me my scrutinize roll. As in a 13.
All right, so on a 13, you're looking to give her what Matthias is attempting to portray, why he's attempting to portray it, and what lies underneath.
Ha! Sorry.
Now I'm having to dig into a mind that is not necessarily very.
I mean, a mind. Ain't there like seven of them in there by this point?
He's trying to show. Resolve and a little bit of indifference, but there is a combination of regret, apology, and sorrow under that, and he's just trying to soldier on through it.
Resolve to
put that, one okay, foot that in front was what of. He's portraying. And that was what lies underneath. Why is he attempting to portray resolve and apathy? Like, what are those? What purpose are those supposed to serve? Is that for everybody else's benefit?
It's for everyone's benefit, his and theirs, and just combining that with getting the job done.
He's. Because what I'm getting this, well, if I were Sam, I think what I'd be picking up is he is carrying on in her place for the time being.
He just saw something worse than death that he didn't have much of a choice in, right? So he did what had to be done, and he did it so ain't nobody else got to do it. But rather than being a self-pitying pile of selfish asshole, he's instead attempting to be a pillar so that you don't have to be right now, because he understands that this ain't fun. And like, what else the hell are you gonna do?
Would you say that's accurate, Chris?
Yeah, like pretty much everything that the three of us all said are kind of.
That's a donation from Jekyll 351. 15 says a crit for each Matthias, Finn, and Sam. Great RP all. Thank you, Jekyll. Thank you, sir. Glad to hear you're enjoying the show. It's also worth noting, forgive me if I overstep myself explaining Matthias at any point, Kajer, but Matthias is a character Kajer has played for a long time and in many different games. And I like to think I know the guy a little bit. It's been my job to fuck with his head for like half a decade now.
and play part of his head.
Mostly, yeah. Now, the marshal takes a moment to consult the map. Oh yeah. That's right. So, y'all are, y'all are walking up around this tunnel, marching on in silence. Emmy is trying to... Emmy is mostly failing at doing what you done do... did. Doobity. Matthias. Where Matthias is soldiering on, he does a damn good job of just going stone cold face, shutting off, and being strong. Emmy ain't used to this. She's being real quiet. She's trying to not draw too much attention to herself because she has been shook to her core. You guys march on. Unsurprisingly, finding yourself some more blood on the ground. That bodes poorly. But you already know about the monstrosities that crawl through the mines now. No idea where they came from or why they're here. And as you come up around the corner, you're pretty damn sure you ain't been down this place before. And normally, those damn pustules only burst when you get near, but this one's already done opened up, wet and glistening in its middle. So, if this is where it hatched, where'd it go?
I'm going to take a second, because partially try and give myself something to focus on and distract myself, and partially because I ain't had the chance to get real close in this circumstance, I'm going to use the tip of my shotgun to kind of poke around in the middle of it to find out like if it comes from anywhere. Like, these are in the ground, but are they coming up from underneath? Does something like put it on top? Like, I don't know anything about these creatures.
All right. So, well, I figured out what the hell I'm supposed to tell you in response to that question, because welcome to life with the PCs, I guess. It is top of the hour. So, what a convenient time for me to have a moment to think a think. Well, what else do you call them? They're thinks. You go and you have yourself a little think, all right? That's what you do. Think, think, think.
You do the poo bear.
Yeah.
I thought you were just going to say you do the poo, and I was like, I don't understand.
No, I'm doing this. I'm thinking doing the poo is more like, like.
Now, doing the poo is a great time to do the think, but.
It is true, but they are not the same thing. So what we're going to do is
they are not mutually inclusive is what my. Compadres are trying.
I'm gonna start up the music. Who can man the guns? Jesus.
What now, indeed?
Today, the role of Matt shall be played by Serranus. I hereby award you one Matt point for talking over a logo splash.
I promise you, you do not want to know what happens if you get too many points.
You become a hurricane.
And I'll rock you like a hurricane.
Rock you like a hurricane. Okay, so.
I was trying to find a good hurricane song. I'm glad you found one first.
How do you not know that song?
I know that song. It just wasn't one that jumped to mind immediately.
I can't hear the word hurricane without thinking that song. A moment of silence for Chris's reputation for having any taste in music.
Wait, I had a reputation?
Oh, yeah. Anything? You got yourself a reputation, all right.
You've got seven reputations.
So, you poke that thing in the ground with your shotgun, right, Matthias?
Yeah.
And the GM goes and has a thing, and the GM comes back. GM still has no idea. So, GM's going to make it up as he goes along, because that's what this GM does. So, the marshal looks at his players across the table, peeringly. And he says, Matthias, the tip of your shotgun there is a little wet. You definitely notice that the mound of flesh grows up from beneath the dirty earth of the mine floor.
I'm going to move some of the gunk aside and see if, like, there's a... if there's any kind of, like, tube or anything at the bottom of it.
Oh, it's not slush. The bottom of that is a solid concave kind of wet, red, exposed, fleshy dip like an open wound.
But is there anything in the bottom of it then?
Nope. You might, I don't know, dig around it to find out how far down it goes. But it would appear that these ticks with their hairy insectoid legs seem to grow entirely encased in whatever this little pus bubble is before they burst out. They're not crawling out of anything. They're not coming from nowhere.
I'm just trying to figure out how these egg things get there. They gotta get here some way. I did see them vine-looking things before. I'll save the digging for later, because I recall being informed that we might have somebody in distress down here. So if I can't find anything immediately, I'll continue on.
All right.
Wait for a bit later to check this part out.
You can continue down the hallway if you'd like. You gotta kind of press yourself up against the wall to squeeze past, not to leave, you know, flesh in your footprints. Tunnel seems to narrow up a little bit as you're moving through. You can continue to feel free exploring. I'll call for a stop the moment I realize that I had done fucked something up. There is a set of tracks on the ground here, and yes, before you ask, it is live, but easy to step over, what with the dust and the dirt on top of it.
I'm still not going to trust it, so I'm going to be pretty careful. I've already been electrocuted twice.
It's been more than twice. Oh, you just mean in this dungeon alone? Yeah, twice.
Yeah. I'm sorry, three, including the liver.
Yep. It's a bit of a pastime now. Hold on. Hold your horses. Keep your shirt on down there. Finn. You seem to have paused up at the top of the tracks with Emmy. Is there a reason? You got something you want to narrate there?
I was going to pick up Emmy and carry over the tracks.
All right. You reach out to pick Emmy up, right? And your physical touch actually startles her. And she just about jumps out of her skin before she realizes it's just you. Almost like you snuck up on her, even though you've been there the whole time. And she'll... and then she'll nod, and without a word, she'll play along with you picking her up and moving her over the tracks.
Well, she still has that crystal leg thing going on.
Oh, yeah.
So I have to help her along.
She ain't got the use of her leg, because it done got infected by one of the crystals. That's right. All right. So... down alongside the tracks we're going. To make things just a little bit speedier here, I can move y'all down. Oh, I think Sam just discovered. There it is. Another open pustule.
So we're looking for at least two now.
You're missing two of them.
Were there more bodies, or did we fight more of them than there were eggs in the last, in the...
Every last prairie tick you've seen, you've watched hatch.
All right.
You're also presented with a choice. You can go south or west.
Which way?
There does not seem to be much information regarding which ways you have available to you.
Just pick one.
Look back and forth between the tunnels. I'll shrug and motion east.
Thias motions east and starts heading down the hallway. Matthias stops and starts heading the other way.
Yeah, because I saw a pool of blood. I want to make sure there was...
Ain't nobody there. Definitely looks like there was some kind of struggle, though. Maybe a person done got eaten. Sam, you're standing there at the edge of those crystals.
I'm like shining my light down through them.
And you're like shining your light down through, and they just seem to go on and on and on. Barely enough room for you to squeeze through. Maybe if you did a little climbing, but...
I'm going to use my face. My insect.
All right. I believe the last time we did this, because I ain't got shit for that token yet. Actually, hold on. I do. If I search correctly. Oh, no. It's going to be in maps. Oh, I think I got this. Sam, Sarah, you're going to be so happy with me. I promise it's going to be awesome. Say what? I might have just the right thing. Where is it?
Oh, no. There's far too much glee.
I like having a collection that's so big I can't find nothing. Holy shit. There it is. Oh. I remember noticing this when I was building Everdeep recently. and going, man, there's no use for that. Wait a minute. Come on, where are you?
I'm not really excited to see it.
Zhang should know what's going on. He built the map.
Right.
No, Zhang don't know shit. Name. I'm calling it the Bug Traption.
The Bug Traption.
And you are yellow, right? That's your thing?
I am.
Boom! Look at that! One little steampunk Ornithopter coming right up.
That is awesome!
I knew you'd like it.
I love it. Alright.
That comes from the same asset set that we use for all the steampunk stuff. It's called Steampunk Industrial Interiors, and I do not know who creates it right now, because that would involve going through the market and finding it again. But that's where you can find that. So, you got a this bug has got to do a little bit of navigating. Now, to refresh everybody's memories, Sam is a mad scientist who invents all kinds of steampunk contraptions. Now, Sam is actually, what you're doing there, if I'm not mistaken, you actually can't, this doesn't have sight of its in and of itself. It's got a little light source on it, though, right?
Right.
All right. So, all players see light, but it does not have sight. And technically speaking, you ain't supposed to. There. I'm sorry. Now, because you're not supposed to have vision from this token, I can't actually let you control it.
That's fine.
So you want to fly down the hallway here.
Right.
Right. And this is what the light is exposing for you just before it gets out of sight. Now, the way this contraption works is there is a little firefly in there that's got some kind of dark magic to it. And it resonates with a bit of goo that you've pulled from its abdomen, all right? And whenever the bug is scared, that goo vibrates as if there is some connection between the two. Now, you were attacked by a bear at one point, so you have a faceplate on the side of your head, right? And inside of that plate is a little capsule of this goo. And then you made this little fly machine to put the bug inside of so you can fly it around, and it serves as a scouting system. But at this point here... around the corner. It does seem that there is an end to these crystals, but you can't see around the corner where they end.
Is it sensing danger?
It is not sensing any danger that is triggering it, no. I'm assuming you wanted to fly back then?
Yeah. Well, there's crystals and crystals and crystals and crystals, and that's about all I know.
Kind of peer over, and I'll be like, all right, well, let's try the other way first before we have to navigate that nonsense.
All right.
Back we go.
Okay, so y'all decided to go south here. Mm-hmm. Class and Sam combined to become an orange character for some reason. They're so weird looking. Watch this, ready? Watch, ready? Oh, hold on. What happens if I do everybody all at once? It becomes like this puke green. That's really weird.
Huh.
Because the auras are transparent on the ground.
Right, yeah. That's kind of cool.
Oh, Matthias, be real careful. You just caught the glint of it's a dead end with a growing crystal.
Fuck.
This place is a bit like a maze. It's almost like the folks who were digging here didn't really have much of a plan.
Actually, I think that the plan for these mines is that there's just an arbitrary series of obstacles to prevent us from going where we want to go.
Are you musing this out loud?
Yes.
Matthias, you can take a white ship. You actually have the madness that was assigned to you from the damn book. That you actually think you are some character in a game.
Yeah,
and because you are tactfully and tastefully implementing this, I will give you a white chip.
I'll ask, can you put the firefly up there?
Put it up where?
Like, have it scout out again?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, you just want on the other side of the crystals?
Yeah. So we can see. Oh, this ain't gonna be pretty.
Alright, so you are faced with a claustrophobic cluster of sharp, nasty, pointy teeth. You have identified the cause, the curse that these things impart, what they infect you with. And these are green crystals. Oh yeah, these are the ones that make you more likely to bleed out. They make your body brittle. They make you more likely to take more damage from every attack that actually hits you. In short, mechanically, they lower your size, which means that it takes 1 point less damage to actually wound you.
Now, wait, if it decreases our size, does it actually shrink us?
No, it makes you less solid, like your skin becomes a little more brittle, your bones become a little more shaky, your flesh becomes a little weaker. It's easier to tear apart.
By the way, I'd forgotten because it's been so long since we played Judasir. I just had to go back and verify when I am ever rolling dice again, and I just wanted to be said that if anybody ever wants to see me succeed ever again, I'm going to need donations.
Shameless. Absolutely shameless.
Well, I could lie and tell them that I'm not going to die, but I just looked at the number of botches that Robo
did. You're going to die.
And I'm very likely to die horrifically.
I don't need Robo's help to kill you horrifically, son. Trust me, no. Killing Sam was just one small step on the path to many things worse than death that awaits you.
I'm gonna motion the others through, and I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna make sure. No, I'll just be like, you guys go through first. I'll bring up the rear.
I'll go through first in case I gotta drag any of your asses through.
All right, Sam, how do you plan on going about squeezing through this tunnel?
Well, let's see, shall we?
This might not be your first instinct, but you as a player should be aware that you do have this thing sleeping inside of you, and you can ask it for assistance. It is not lying when it says when it encourages a decent relationship of some kind, even if it's not friendly.
Mm-hmm. And that doesn't have to be related to any of the stuff that I've gotten. It's just
You have the mechanics and stats for those abilities, but your character doesn't know what those are yet.
Right.
So if just as a player, you should be aware that that is an avenue available to you, and it might have knowledge and shit that you don't have. I'm more than happy to play this out in whatever direction seems natural.
I was thinking of using, and I don't know if this would actually help much, but fast as death.
Which was that?
That's the one that increases your speed, but I'm not sure if that would assist me that much in getting me through these crystals.
The essence of that power is like the Flash's move speed. It's a mm-hmm. quick blur. I would allow you a small bonus for applying that. If you can come up with a reason why moving faster makes you less likely to get cut by any of these crystals.
Well, isn't it more a matter of, like, if you're going to have us make checks multiple times to get through this many crystals?
That is exactly my question.
You do have an ability that will increase your physical attributes.
That was my second one. That was
That ability would be more suited, in my opinion. The move speed isn't going to save you from nimbly bimbly squeezing through.
Wait, which one is the...
I think I called it Channeled Beast.
Okay. Channel base, where is that?
Do Finn and Emmy look like they're going to start moving towards crystals?
Ellie's getting ready to.
I'm going to take a couple steps back, and I'll just be like, I'm going to go double check to make sure there's no way around.
All right, Matthias.
And don't you grin at me, Marshall.
You done played a whole ton of World of Darkness in your day, I can tell. I didn't use magic, and I don't need nobody to notice, so I'm gonna, with suave and bold-faced lies, figure out exactly how I'm gonna explain all this shit and set it up before I use it, so that way there's no questions.
I have a question.
What's up, sir?
Do the crystals go all the way up and down the wall, or is there a way to?
The mines are only about 7 feet tall, so they are pretty much thoroughly scattered around. Yeah, they're not on the ceiling.
Would they be like all the way down to the floor, or would one be able to crawl under?
If what you want to do is kind of like wriggle down like this, right, mm-hmm. and you want to go underneath, I will allow you a small bonus to make it less likely you get pricked, because you'll be moving very slowly, and you'll be avoiding a lot of the crystals. There are some down there, but you could kind of like around them. So it won't deny, it won't auto-pass you the check, but it'll give you a bonus.
Okay.
When they start going through, I'm going to try and shadow jump across the crystals.
All right, so you want to be there before they get through?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and fail me that hexling roll.
I knew you were going to do that.
Yeah, the thing was is that I botched because of RoboVin, and that's exactly why I was just like, I'm just going to fucking die right now.
All right, did I hear you say that you done went unnatural bust on your hexling roll?
Yes.
All right. So, would you be so kind, Matthias Kajer, as to explain to our audience, knowing full well that there are new people tuning in every week, this game's been blowing up. Explain what happens when the witch, the huckster, the card slinging spirit gambling spellcaster, fucks up his spellcast like this.
Well, there's a series of things. First of all, it means that I have lost a bet with Manitow, which is mischief spirit. And I personally am under the opinion that this is because I have been gambling with Serranus for too long.
And by Serranus, you mean Finn?
I mean Finn.
And by Finn, you mean RoboVin, basically.
No, I've been gambling with Finn for too long. Because
starting to rub off on you?
Yeah, he's starting to rub off on me. I'm getting lax, and the mana tower's starting to pull one over on me more. And so after the mana tower manages to beat me in a game of poker, it will take my body and do what it wants with the power that I give it. And what it wants is what you, the audience, wants, because it's normally a chart to see what the mischief spirit does, because it's a spirit of chaos. But because we have our destiny tokens for you fine viewers, somebody in the audience, if they so choose, gets to pick what it is the Manitow will decide to do in the terrible fuckery of my spell.
So, Pyromancy is in. All right, Pyromancy. Juicedeer, Backlash.
Does he not have that memorized yet? Like the whole table?
I don't know. So you get to tell me what the number is going to be.
What?
When the hell did Kajer say your ball sack is a wolf that's metal as fuck? What is happening in the chat right now? Yeah, stop investigating weird crimes in your neighborhood with your gaggle of high school friends, Nancy. What? All right, so what does Pyromancy want to use his destiny token to pick? You get to pick any of those rolls, 1 to 4, 5 to 8, 9 to 12, 13, 16, or 17 to 20. And then I will interpret what happens to poor Matthias. And in this way, the cycle of
abuse continues.
Yeah, like, basically. I'm pretty certain Pyromancy has had more say in the development of Matthias than you have at this rate.
That is not untrue.
70 to 20. Corruption.
Oh, goodness.
All right, so Matthias. I have the answer. Okay. But before that, I'm going to break it up into two checks for the others, all right? So I'm going to say Finn is probably going in after Sam, because Sam declared she was going first. So what do you do? You're confronted with it's about a 7-foot tall tunnel, right? Shadows flicker in from the electric lights that are kind of like doing that patrolling flashlight spotlight thing underneath your little ornithopter at the other end of the tunnel. And these green translucent crystals that cast absolutely beautiful light patterns all over the ceiling and the floor. And I'm drooling like a motherfucker. I really like green crystals. You don't understand. Green crystals
So here's what I imagine. Yes, as a player, I am activating Channel the Beast, which it raises my physical traits and decreases my mental traits, basically.
Yep.
By one step, which I believe that's a die type, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's what I imagine happens, however. I imagine that I am standing in front of these crystals. Remember what happened last time, because I did get nicked by one of these before.
Yep.
Which, by the way, that size decrease wasn't permanent after I died and then returned, was it? Okay, good. All right. So I'm going to go, oh, hell. And then I imagine that something inside me goes, watch this.
All right. Yeah, okay. So as you're getting ready, right, this thing inside of you says, tell you what, let me show you why you don't want me as your enemy. And you will start to feel the thing inside of you flexing, right? Hold on to your britches, girl. And it's tendrils. It's your mind's eye. Again, like, this is you imagining things, but you aren't the one choosing to imagine them. This is an imagination coming to you, right? Your mind's eye. It thinking about it. And you can, its tendrils kind of like flowing into your arms and your legs, right? And this is, it makes things a little intense. Your heart starts pounding and you can feel the power this thing is giving you, and it's a little, you can start to see a tad bit of that gray misty astral realm we call the hunting grounds. Just barely you can see moving shapes and shadows, but you can't see the actual realm itself. It's distracted, it's confusing, you feel a little high, but your body has never been so quick, so strong, so nimble. And as you take that first step, it guides your motions and it assists you. Roll me your newly enhanced nimbleness.
Now, here's the problem. I will have disadvantage on this check thanks to RoboVan. So I believe that my power raises the die type, and RoboWin's disadvantage will lower it back down to a normal roll. Is that correct?
Correct.
All right, then I will give you a nimbleness check, sir. And I got 3 fives.
You got a five. A five will do for the first half, all right?
All right.
So you're coming up, and you're about this far. All right, now, moving on up ahead, the crystals get a little more jagged, a little larger. They're going to be a little harder to avoid on the next roll, all right?
Well, my next roll I will crit thanks to Sinatra.
All right. So as you're moving along here, thank you, Sinatra. As you're moving along here, right, and you're starting to reach out and grab, but as you go and lay your hand down, the tendrils will like snap your wrist off to the side and put it down, and you'll catch a glint. There's a tiniest bit of crystal sticking up out of the floor, hidden by the dust that it just saved your hand from. And you'll kind of pull yourself up, and you'll learn that listening and flowing with it instead of fighting against it isn't a terrible idea. And as you're crawling out the other side next to this ornithopter, that voice inside you. It's not just your body anymore. Remember that.
A shudder will ripple through me. And I'll pick up the bug, put a bag in my face. The things that come out of my mouth on the
show. I know, right? This game.
And I look back down the hall. No, Matthias. And I look back over here. No, Matthias.
I don't know where I am right now.
Yeah, I'm going to handle him in a moment.
All right.
There, now I have the bug traption token easy to drag out like so. Boom. All right, so.
And I still really have nothing to say to this thing. I mean, I don't understand it is the problem.
Yeah, you don't know what
because
it is.
As a woman of science, this is far beyond the realm of science. Mm-hmm. And that is is an abomination as far as she's concerned. So
I understand that you may feel slightly violated. And then I may have taken away some of your rights as a human being. But fortunately, you're not a human being anymore, so it's okay.
There are things in this heaven and earth, oh Sam, that your science has never dreamt of. Now, Emmy and Finn, I'm going to give you guys an advantage. You're going down like this. I'm going to give you +2. So the first roll is TN5, give me nimbleness. And we're gonna impose disadvantage on Emmy's rolls. So who wants to roll Emmy at a D4? Sorry, 3D4.
I'll do it, because I get to roll dice.
Those oh, didn't shit. Explode.
Yeah, my bad.
Finn, you were also muted. And that was a total of 9.
I had disadvantage, so it dropped me down to 3D8 rather than 3D10. So I get a total of 9.
She gets 10.
All right. So Finn and Emmy, one right behind the other, will make it about this far. Now, this is about when Matthias is going to, quote-unquote, find another way around. And here's the deal. All right, Matthias.
Yeah.
Do you see where you are right now?
Right.
I want you to keep following this token. All right.
All right. I'm
what is your what is it? What does your spell cast look like? Well, I'm slowly dragging it across the walls.
Where am I going? So in this particular case, where am I?
I ain't finished moving you yet. I just need to know what the actual teleportation spell looks like, even though the others can't see it.
All right, so when I come out of the hunting ground, what I'll do is I'll I'll throw the card forward.
Yep.
And I'll take a couple of run and I'll as it's falling forward, I'll run at it and catch it to kind of like project myself forward.
All right, so you're pulling a Nightcrawler then, right? So yeah. You get your cards, you toss it forward, and you push off with your mechanical steampunk leg, and you kind of jump up and snatch the card out of the air, and then poof, in like that swirly black smoke, you will vanish, and then you will reappear. Surprise!
What is that?
That is nom nom nomming on your feet. So since you have stepped inside of a tooth trap, we're gonna deal you 3d8 to your good leg, because your bad leg can't really be chewed on. For a total of 23 damage to that leg. Now you are size 6, correct?
That is 3 wounds. Is that so?
Did I just cost you another leg?
No, I'm just thinking. Because I got a bunch of chips. I just need to know how many I'm spending on this. I'll spend 2 of my whites.
So you only take 1 wound?
So I'll take 1 wound because I've already got 3 to the upper guts because I'm bleeding everywhere.
All right. You will also lose 5 wind in the process.
That's all right.
So basically, as Finn and Emmy, you are crawling over Sam, you are looking around and like it's fading. The beast's power is, and it's pulling back because you are still in control. And you're the haze will leave you and you start to see reality normal again. Well, as normal as reality can be, I suppose. And Matthias, that is where you disappear into a poof black smoke. Now, Sam, that thing inside of you just heard something. Right. But you don't know what it is. You just imagine that I snap it up and looking around. Like it's aware of something that it wasn't aware of before. And now, Matthias, you will pop out, and beneath you, as displayed on the stream here, there is this ring of teeth with a tongue and saliva. It's not quite the Sarlacc pit that you've encountered before. This looks like it's growing out of the same kind of flesh that those pustules would normally grow out of, but this time it's hungry, and it's got you by the leg. You done stepped directly in its mouth as you come out the other side of that teleport, and it's gonna start gnawing up your leg, and the saliva's burning at your skin, and the teeth are ripping down your leg, pulling little strips of skin and muscle and blood flowing down towards your ankles. That's gonna be quickness rolls from everybody, please.
Ow, you son of a... Ow! Ow, get off my leg! Ow, you son of a... I will... Ow!
Now, the thing inside me, what is its reaction to it? to whatever it heard or felt? Yeah.
So it's like it's alert. It's not feeling threatened, but it's very aware, right? Like, almost like, did I just smell prey?
Ah. Right?
And then you hear Matthias going, ow, ow, my leg, like screaming, his voice echoing off the hallways up ahead of you somehow, right? And the demon inside of you just thinks that is downright amusing.
That makes my decision. I will, as a player, activate Unholy Reflexes, which gives me more action cards in a round.
Yep.
And level of power is at 1, which means I get...
It does take an action to activate, but I'll let you throw it up at the start of the combat because it's unholy reflexes.
Okay.
So basically, just consider that to be passive. As long as you want to use the power, you can get it.
To use an action to get an extra action?
Yeah, that doesn't make any sense, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to say that's on, but you have to declare you're using the power. And then the other powers have an activation speed. So for example, to channel the beast, you have to spend an action card to activate that power. All right?
Gotcha. Got it.
I think the best way that I figured out is that it takes 1 action and it works for the whole combat.
I don't mind just leaving 21. It. I honestly don't mind just giving her an action card.
Why the fuck does everybody have 12s on quickness?
Is that 5 cards then?
Uh-huh.
It's 2, but it's 1. And then 5, 10, 15, 20. So 5, plus 10, 15, 20, plus 1.
Plus an extra action card. 6.
Fuck everybody.
I get to be the baddest of asses.
I did tell you.
You did tell me.
I did tell you that if you struck this guy, I will.
Oh, wait. Which one's the Red Joker?
The name should be colored appropriately.
No, I know, but what does it do? Which I forget which one's
red.
Bad.
Red is
like
good.
A sleeve one, right?
Red is good. Red is a good one.
Black is bad.
Okay, I'll discard my lowest and redraw.
Did you get a Red Joker?
I did.
All right. That what you're gonna do is you can you that goes up your sleeve, which means that you can use it to after you hear an action declared, but before we start reacting to it and rolling it out, you can spend your Red Joker to react
to
intercede. All right. Now, so you're discarding this.
Yep, and redraw.
And redraw. We're gonna put. We'll just use this neat little pile here. Okay. So. Everybody done got their right cards, so I'm gonna draw 2 cards.
Do I have to discard the Joker right now and then declare it later?
You just need to let me know you got it, all right? Sure. So, all right. Aces.
That I do.
All right, it's your turn to pull. We'll have Amy go on your actions as well.
Well, on this roll, I crit because of a Jekyll 351.
All right, and roll me Emmy.
That's 3d4.
Currently,
If he's critting, does that mean that he can still take an action this round?
I'll say he doesn't spend any of his pace on that as his crit bonus.
Oh, excellent.
So he's still spending his card to get out, but he's not spending any of his movement.
Does she get +2 on this roll as well?
Yeah. Fine, sure.
I got it.
Oh, okay.
Actually, you got it.
You both rolled a damn 7. She barely squeezes out.
9 for Emmy.
So she's gonna crawl up and shove herself to her feet right behind you, Finn. All right. That was on aces.
Mm-hmm.
Kings. Queens. Jacks.
I have a jack.
Sarah has
it's going to go hearts, then diamonds, then clubs. Reverse alphabetical.
You're also muted, Sarah.
Sorry, I have 2 jacks.
How dare you? Wait, you have 2 of those? Which ones are you?
I am the clubs and hearts.
So she goes first, and then I go, and then she goes.
Sam Matthias Sam. All right, let's hear it.
I have a singular intent, and that is to find him wherever he is.
All right.
So I guess move action. I would
say follow the screaming.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty easy, but I don't know how far away he is, I don't think.
Nah, because it echoes in here all weird-like. So so you can basically, you can spend, you. How much pace do you have?
Well, I'm thinking about doing the fastest death thing now.
All right. So that'll be your
my
action.
My pace is 6, I think, right? Or whatever the base is normal.
No, there is no normal pace. It's the result of your nimbleness and and strength types, I think.
Got you. So that would be 12 then.
All right. So you can move up to 6 with no penalty. All right. But as you're around the corner, you can see that Matthias has got his leg stuck.
Wait, is it the result? Wait,
hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, then I'm not going to activate the thing.
Yep.
I'm just going to move up to it because, you know, melee.
You can get to this square right here.
That's it?
Without triggering the running penalty. If you move further than that, if you move further than that and you don't choose to spend your action activating the power, you will suffer the run penalty.
I'm going to move up there and shoot the thing.
All right, don't botch.
I won't, but I will have disadvantage thanks to pyromancy.
All right, let's see that go and bust.
Hold on. I gotta find out what my die type is for Gatling pistol.
It is just nimbleness for piss.
Oh, it's just your nimbleness die type.
Uh huh.
Yeah, I was trying to look.
Oh shit! I didn't do exploding. It doesn't matter. I got a 7.
All right, you got a 7. That'll hit.
Does damage doesn't decrease?
It hits once. Right. Your damage is still the same for the normal damage.
21.
21. Well, it's dead.
Yeah.
Really, that's it?
It doesn't have a massive size.
Yeah.
If it is size 4 or less, you done killed. Sorry, 3 or less, you done killed it, which is exactly what it has.
Okay, then. How's his leg?
Chewy.
So Sam, right? You are moving. You have the thought. Like, you're not just thinking on your own now. There are two minds inside your head, right? Mm-hmm. And as you start thinking with your intent and your concerns, you find your brain is kicking up a second processor. And it is hijacking everything that thing is thinking, and you're thinking twice. So with dual core brain power, you immediately react way faster than you have ever reacted on the field of battle before. And you come roaring, your gun's already drawn, and you've already shot before your one mind figures out what the hell just happened.
Which gun did she fire?
She fired her Gatling pistol. Roll me jam.
That exploded.
Did it?
Yes.
That's right. I don't have any ranged weapons, I'm pretty sure. I'm sorry. I forgot.
Okay, so do you want to take the running penalty and use a melee attack roll instead?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, shit. What's your highest wound penalty?
Well, that's an interesting question. Because I had a 2.
It would get healed.
Yeah.
Because while the scars persist, the damage to your body is gone.
The death, she hasn't slept, though. She just stood up.
Yeah, but you, you regenerate.
Instantaneously? I know you don't, I know you regenerate each night. No, it's that they have a naturally increased healing rate with the healing rolls.
Yeah, I wasn't sure because of...
So she didn't stand up all nice and patched up except for the fire wounds. It's just the fire wounds scarring and it's never going away because that was what killed her.
In any case, the highest wound penalty I have is 2.
Alright, that means you're going to add 2d4 to all of your melee attack damage rolls. Because you've got, don't get him riled, the exactly. Beast does not appreciate taking damage.
So, now my arm, is it fine?
Yeah, your arm is functional. And yes, its die type increase does stack with Channel the Beast if you want to use that.
Oh,
but
well,
that'll cost you your action card.
So I'm rolling 3d12 exploding plus 2d4 exploding for attack. That's for attack rolls.
I think
the damage
is damage.
Yeah, get riled is damage, not attack.
All right, so this is attack 11, and then I assume that hits.
That hits all nice.
Roll
and back.
Damage for arm is 3d6, 3d8. No, does that one increase?
Those don't increase. Your strength dice increase. The d6s don't.
It's 2d4 exploding. 23.
Shockingly, you roll more damage in melee than you did elsewhere. So instead of rolling up and shooting, by the time your brain catches up and you suddenly realize, and you realize what you just did, your fist is already inside this fleshy thing and ripped a tooth out and stabbed this thing 3 times, and it's already twitching and dead. And that felt really good. Matthias? She was just there. Out of nowhere from the shadows, ripping this thing apart. And now you're both covered in weird yellow-colored bloody gunk.
Two things.
Are you stood up or are you sitting down?
I'm standing in it. I'll look down at her for a second. For the record, that might look appetizing to you, Sam. Out of character.
Yeah.
But I'll look down at her as she just comes out of nowhere, and I still got the same expression. I'll just be like, thanks.
You're welcome. You're hurt.
I still got one metal leg.
I'll put my hand out and touch his leg and stitch it up.
Do you got the medicine, the first aid skills?
No, but I have stitching.
That only applies
to you.
Oh, it only applies
to
me?
That's, yes. Okay. Basically, stitching is, you've got Wolverine regeneration.
Yeah, all right.
You're fucking Deadpool, lady.
That's awesome.
What do you do with the, what do you do with the tooth?
The tooth?
Hey, you ripped it.
That
tooth.
I ripped out. The,
She suddenly realizes she's holding a weapon like,
I discard that, but what does the pile of mess that I've just created look like?
Flesh.
Ground beef.
God, I am hungry.
Currently, it looks like pulled pork.
Yeah. I'll look down. I'll hear that. Nod a little to myself. And then reach down, grab the tooth. Wiggle a couple others free. And I see the others coming up behind. I'll be like,
don't let them see me.
I'll be like, I won't even register there. I won't even acknowledge what she said. I'll be like, let's go check the passage up there. Sam's going to check the one down here.
All right.
And I will fall on this body ravenously.
Yep. Could take a white chip. And now that you have consumed at least 1 pound of meat, you will be able to roll for your healing. I think it's once every 6 hours for Sam.
It is once every 6 hours, yes.
Yep. And that's once every 3 days, I think, for a normal person.
Week.
It's once a week? Ooh. All right. Matthias, Emmy, Finn, you discover up around here that there is yet another popped open pustule that makes 3 unaccounted for. This tunnel seems to be a little less rife with, you know, things in the floor trying to eat you.
Yep.
What is your margin order right now?
Matthias is going to try and squeeze past the others to...
Hold on. Stop. Pause, Matthias. Take a step back here. Right there. I just need to know. Okay, that was... Tyson has donated 10. Says 2 crits. 1 for Finn, 1 for Matthias. Hashtag Finthias. Hashtag best couple. Hashtag rule 34. Hashtag Finn will be ever deep. The reason, Matthias, is that it is not a good day for your legs. As you can see here. So, here's what I'm gonna handle Sam for a minute, okay? And then I'll come back to y'all. So Sam.
I don't know what to roll for this.
You ain't got it.
Okay.
You are hungry, right? And as you are descending on this thing, you will be shared. You will simply begin to know things. Your mind's eye will reveal this to you. You may conclude this is the thing that lurks inside of you, sharing information that will aid both of you in surviving. But you're not hearing a voice telling you these things. You know, you have to eat flesh to have flesh. And you are flesh. Though your body is dead and you can't kill what's already dead, you can destroy it. The demon, however, is fully capable and invested in making certain that you stay stitched up. But it's gotta have meat to make meat. And you hunger. Also, it might not be a bad idea to start drinking, because you're a corpse, and alcohol has a habit of pickling you. Better to smell like a drunk than smell like the dead.
While I am feeling what it is sharing with me. And literally eating the freshly dead flesh of some ground creature that I just ripped apart with my bare hands. Mm-hmm. She will start to cry. Because she would rather be dead. But Jet is still out there. So she's literally like eating flesh and sobbing at the same time.
Yeah. So while you were having that experience, Matthias, you squeeze past the others, you're looking to get ahead. You get past them, all right. It's easy enough to get past Emmy. She's not home right now. You get the idea that she witnessed something. You get the idea that she knows a little more than she's letting on. I mean, she always knows more than she's letting on, right? And the way that she's reacting, that was not just, I just saw death. Especially not in the Weird West. Out here in the Weird West, you see people die. You see people hung. You see people shot. Duels at high noon. Bandits. The things that everybody out here has witnessed. And you know damn well she's seen worse than that. But this, oh no, she knows something. She saw, she felt. She's aware, and she cannot handle it. So she's not home right now, and as such, it is easy to squeeze by her. And from Matthias' perspective, it might be a good thing that you did, because you done stepped in a damn Sarlacc pit. So now, your good leg. Gonna take 11 damage, which is gonna spill out to one wound because you ain't got that hit. So you can spend a watch hip to prevent that if you would like. Alright, so as you step on the sand, it gives way beneath your foot, and this has already happened one too many times before. You're gonna stumble back, right? Emmy is gonna grab the gun out of Finn's hand. Last word, your rifle? Is that last word?
Last word is my Colt Dragoon.
All right. What's
the name? It'll be in my holster. It would be in my holster.
All right. So
my Winchester 76 is the one that's in my hands.
All right. So you're holding it, but you got a grip on it because you're looking for something down the hallway. So she's just gonna reach over all nimble like, as if she's got years of experience being a pickpocket, and just snatch the last word out of your holster and fan the bullets out of that thing. Boom! 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 And Matthias, there will like. You ever seen that moment in the movies where the bad guys are like, dance, and shoot at the bat, and shoot at your feet, right? So you're having that moment, except for you didn't get the warning, and all those bullets plug into that thing's flesh, its wriggling, wormy teeth coming, and just shuddering all around this, like little splashes of blood, gut, sand, and dirt, just boom, 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 and then it'll shudder and fall dead. And then Emmy will shove the gun back into Finn's holster. And she's got this look in her eye like she has had enough of these fucking mines, but she don't say a word.
I don't blame you.
Like, after the dust kind of settles and the blood stops spurting, I'll just look up at her, I'll nod. I'll just keep walking like nothing happened.
You know you done set up a dungeon all nice and right, like when the party reaches a point where they go, I fucking hate this place. This is unnatural. I want to leave. But they still keep going. It'll take you a bit to squeeze by, so you're just starting to feel sated. It doesn't take much. Pound of meat. It's like one of the smaller store packages of hamburger, which is about what it looks like. You got like the meat kind of smashed up on your lips, right? And you feel sad and you can stop, right? The beast doesn't make you do it. And you get the idea that maybe next time you might just, you know, order a steak. And you can start to feel your body already. It's imagine the sensation of your skin rapidly growing, of your flesh kind of like moving along your bones just a little bit. It's almost like your body is crawling all over itself. But the pain starts to subside. And you kind of wipe your face off, and that's where bam, 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 bam! And then you hear the shuffle and the footsteps. Fuck. Now, as y'all come round the corner, still more blood smears. All those prairie ticks that done hatched, still can't see them, but you definitely see their handiwork and the smears all over the floor. You're in some kind of big open chamber. Matthias, you're walking along and you reach up to the shadows as Sam is starting to slowly pick herself back together, and you see a ladder that seems to sink deeper into the earth.
Oh, fuck's sake.
I will rub my hands over my face.
Coming up from the hole, you hear a distant echo of a voice. A human voice. Soft. Not distressed. You can't quite make out the words, but that tone of voice, that is definitely, it's definitely a young girl of some kind. But she doesn't seem to be screaming, or her voice ain't trembling. Either this is a trick some evil, unnatural thing is playing on you, or Sally's down there. And if she ain't scared, you probably got all kinds of reasons to be.
I will sigh. I will look up. Shake my head a little. I'll look down. Not at the lighter, but just down. Shake my head again. And I'll get on the ladder and start climbing.
Matthias going down the ladder. What about Finn and Emmy? Emmy, by the way, as Matthias starts going down, look over at Finn and say, you best start reloading.
And he will nod and start reloading both of his guns.
Since I hear the sound of reloading and stuff going on above me, I'm gonna lean back against the tunnel that I'm in. I'm gonna draw my cards, and I'm actually gonna cast me some Shadow Man.
Did she use the full clip, by the way?
Yeah, she unloaded all six.
Okay. Okay, cool.
Alright, so roll me your hex slinging, Matthias.
In a strange thing, I am actually rolling hex slinging because I have disadvantage from Robo.
You're actually rolling. What attribute is Shadow Man based on?
I don't know, because I had it all macro. One sec.
Shadow it has been Man. So long since Chris rolled dice at this table that he done forgot what his damn stats are.
It's smarts. smarts is D10, so that goes down to a D.
When's he used them? It's kind of like me not knowing my own phone number. When was the last time I fucking called myself?
I have to look up everything. Yeah, I have no idea what my stats are. No idea.
All right, so I'm rolling 5d8.
All right.
This is weird.
This is with the downgrade from Robovan's disadvantage?
Yeah.
All right.
This is weird. I don't understand how hexes work anymore. 11.
On an 11. All right. So you get 5 cards off the top of the huckster deck. Right?
Which is not on the screen for
yeah,
me.
Yeah, I'm fixing that.
Well, it does. I think you've changed it so it doesn't have to be on the screen for us. It's just him.
I didn't have it either.
Let me shuffle that real quick. Recall all of them, make sure they're all there, then shuffle them up. All right, Matthias, now, You have, you got 11. That's, the TN is 5, right? So 5 cards, and then you get another one at 10, and another one at 15. So you're going to get 6 cards. All right. Oh, no, I was gonna pull them off the deck and put them on the table.
Oh.
Just drop your 6 cards, because you had one left over, keep in mind.
Yeah, because they go into separate things if they're from separate.
Oh, do they?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. All right. So.
I think that's just a pair for me.
Pair of 9s is what you got. All right. What does a pair give you for Shadow Man?
It is, I believe, the second. Hold on. I need to double check what the state of hexes are, because I think the minimum success might be just, it might be a pair or it might be high card, because for some reason some of them only have high card.
Yeah.
My base hand required for this. That is not the right section of that rule at all.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is why the spellcaster should be looking up his spells before he casts them. Thank you for being a poster boy.
I would actually have to roll it.
I know, right?
I was just like, I'll just critter botch. We know what happens. Now that we actually have disadvantage in the works, I'm actually going to have to start learning my rules again.
Damn.
This is strange and vaguely unsettling to me. Shadow Man is the base hand is pair. So that is just 5 to my stealth roll.
All right. Plus 5 flat.
Yep.
All right. So you bust out the cards. They appear in your hand for a moment, and your mind projects into the hunting grounds. There is no need to go looking for a Manitou for this one. And you can feel. You don't even need to play the damn hand, right? As you're sitting in this table, in this mindscape of yours, this gray, blue, misty landscape of the dead and the damned. And you're sitting there, and there ain't nobody across the table from you. And there's just a curtain of tendrils hanging over your head. And they sink down, a couple of them, and extending further than the others. And they slither along your arms, and they place your hand down on the table, and you hear this creature, this Manitou, whisper, "I fold." Under its grisly breath in your ear, even though there ain't nobody there to talk. And then as you snap back, the shadows inside of this tunnel seem to warp and shift. They're still looking natural, but they are masking you real nice-like.
I will shudder at that, and I'll have to shake my head, because that might actually be the scariest thing I've experienced today. Because that of all the things is that ain't right. Like a Manitou don't just give that. That ain't how that works. So I'll be sitting there in the tunnel, staring at the deck of cards in my hand. And I'll keep going. Making sure that I'm far enough ahead so that people won't notice that I'm not very visible. I'll roll stealth for heading down.
All right.
Going into this, I will have a crit on stealth.
Okay.
We can't hear you, sir.
Who was that from?
That was from Pyromancy, because... Strangely, in
crit from Pyromancy.
Yeah, no, because Pyromancy has decided that he's going to start giving me crits because you're getting the botches.
That's right.
All right, yep. So who's next?
I'll go down next.
After that, Finn, do you want Emmy in the back or in the middle?
In the middle.
All right. I draw your attention, ladies and gents, to the bottom of the ladder. Now, as you slide down the ladder, there is an eyeball at the end of a fleshy stalk that grows up out of the dirt like a vine, and it just blinks watching you. And you can hear that soft chanting. Now you're starting to hear it a little more clearly. And it ain't English, it's Latin. And I don't think anybody here speaks Latin fluently.
I probably know broken Latin.
But there is some joy to that voice as it echoes through the shadows and you hear the sound of heavy objects swinging through the air.
I want to look at this eyeball more.
The eyeball looks at you and it tilts one way and then the other, and then it bows its head as if in a sign of respect. Matthias, you have entered a gaseous area. Please roll me vigor.
Alrighty, I actually get to roll this, which is strange and just overall confusing. I will get an 11.
On an 11, you will pass. You recognize the scent of this. This is the same smell you smelled that triggered your last vision, if you recall. Sam, you don't need to breathe. You are immune.
Wow.
Now,
can I see this gas?
Hold up. You can see it as soon as Sam holds up her torch and walks into it. Sam doesn't have to breathe it, right? You could put on a show of holding your breath if you want.
I don't think that I know enough quite yet to have practice doing that. Right. So I don't.
Now Finn, you've had this as well. I forget what you did again. Oh yeah, you saw the vision of.
It was a prophecy.
Yeah, it was a prophecy of you in a jail cell, right?
Mm-hmm.
With Puck, I think.
With Puck.
Yep.
And something was about to explode from my throat.
Was it?
Yes.
Oh. Well then. I'm going to have to go back and rewatch that so I know what the hell I prophesied.
Just GM things.
Hashtag just GM things. All right, so you do recognize that gas up on ahead because it is slightly oily, reflecting the light of her electric flickering torch.
Made me see things.
Do you move into it or no?
I get out my bandana and I hand it over to Emmy so she doesn't have to breathe it.
All right.
As I...
And you're going in?
Mm-hmm.
All right, roll me vigor. And take a white chip. Looking after Emmy like that. Very nice.
Oh, vigor first.
All right.
I got a 6 because wound penalties.
Oh, yeah. 6 will not be enough. All right, Chet.
Well, are we going to be making multiple rolls for being in the cloud or?
No, once you're in the cloud, you only need to make one roll. If you leave the cloud and enter another one, you're going to make a roll. There will be a truncated mechanic once things really get rolling in here, instead of having this whole 9 yards. Destiny window has closed, so odds prophecy, evens nightmare. Finn, roll me guts. And pull up on the move. I ain't quite finished yet.
Yeah, no.
Give him a thing at a time. So you roll a 7. No, an 8.
Yes.
All right. That'll be enough. You are struck with dark, dark visions. Visions. Mm-hmm. You are certain for just a moment in your hallucinatory state that Antonio Andolini lurks in these shadows. You just know it. The man you owe your life in gold. The man so terrifying that ain't nobody ever laid eyes on his face and lived. The man that you know has been hunting you, whose fingers you have seen in every pie you have crossed. And he is here for you. You will manage to steal yourself. You recognize the gas was here before. So though you believe it with all your heart, you walk forward knowing the Lord will guide your path. And though you walk in the shadow of the valley of Antonio Andolini, you will fear no evil. Emmy will cover her mouth. She'll step in just fine. Now, it is about this time that that Latin chanting will bloom and billow into a chorus. And just up on ahead, in the shadows, you see Sally. Standing in a ring of giant teeth the size of at least half my thighs, if not taller. Curving up out of the ground with giant tendrils the likes of which you have already seen. Swirling and swaying from the earth like limber tall trees. Very reminiscent of that thing that you wrestled into submission when Matthias brought you back from the dead, Sam. However, here there are great eyeballs, each the size of a horse at least, blinking and growing and looking this way and that, and the priest's daughter is on her knees with her hands raised to the heaven, and that joyous chorus you begin to realize was a psalm to her new lord. And she stands up, and she spins, and she laughs. She says, I'm gonna find him. God ain't helped my pappy, but I'm gonna find Puck. I'm gonna be with Puck forever.
Like hell you will.
And roll me quickness.
We don't do crits for quickness, do we?
We do not. It is not an action.
We do disadvantage, but not crits. Okay.
Two questions. One, we still have action cards. Two, I don't have the action deck anymore.
That's because I'm a fool. You should not have action cards right now. Oh. So I'm going to recall all the Hux cards, and then I'm going to wonder where the hell the action deck went, because how did that happen? All right. Hide the Hux deck. Show the action deck. Recall. Shuffle. And for this one, this is going to be, we might have to pause in the middle of this fight, just so you know. Alternatively, we can draw these cards and we can say half an hour to go and give ourselves a whole session to beat down this boss next week. Would you prefer to not cliffhanger in the middle of the combat?
Yes, I would prefer to not do that.
All right, so go ahead and roll all y'all's quickness. All right. I'm going to draw my two.
Draw cards?
Yep. Do all the card draw mechanics so we can get right into the action next week.
Motherfucker.
Did you get the
You got black the black joker? Oh! Yeah, baby!
There is, in fact, a single detriment to having that many cards. I should know this. I'm Hux.
Alright, so Sam discards all her cards. Put these puppies down over here. All right. And then I got my two. All right. So she is convinced, having watched what her father devolved into, that God ain't nothing, but she has found something with tangible power, something that will give her everything she needs to find the love of her life. And you are standing in her way. As we fade to black here on A to Be Continued, you will hear the sickening sound of pustules bursting somewhere in the shadows nearby. I'm Evil Squeegee, I've been your marshal. This is Sam, played by Sarah P. Matthias, played by Kajer. And Finn, played by Serranus. Tune in next week, Friday, 10 a.m. EST, to find out what happens next on Judas Steer. Will the party survive? Who will die next? What in hell's name is going on inside of Sally's head? Only time will tell.